20 years or 30 years ago, I was living in a country which completely collapsed. It was a country where which had the longest siege of a city in modern history, Sarajevo, ethnic cleansing, genocide, and so on. And it was the 90s, and I returned from Germany, where I was, by the way, watching, what was the name of the kid? Actually, one of your colleagues, David Hasselhoff, had this series about
Knight Rider.
A car, Knight Rider, which I think Knight Rider is the anticipation of the smart car, because if you remember the tagline, the tagline was Ein Mensch, ein Computer, ein Auto. So basically, it's, and it was very smart. And then, of course, I returned to Croatia, which was completely fucked up already. Luckily, I lived in Čakovec, Međimurje, so I went very often to Graz. But if you, and then we watched Baywatch on television in the 90s, me and my sister. And for us in Croatia, really, to watch Baywatch at that time and to watch Pamela, it was like, you know, that it was like if it was possible, we imagined as if it was possible to have a different sort of life. Only later we would find out that the American dream is not a dream, that it's only a dream for Warren Buffett, for Jeff Bezos, and for some other mainly white male guys. That would be, we would find out that later, but...
Right.
But at that time, it was a way out, in a way. And if you would told me then, you know, 20, 30 years ago, that I would be sitting with Pamela, I don't know what I would have said because I was too small, but I wouldn't believe it, and I wouldn't believe, you know, even what she is doing now. I think it's so great because first of all, you are completely honest, and that's very rare in the business of.
It's easier.
That's very courageous. You know, you can just imagine what it means to have friends such as Julian Assange and so on, and to go to the Ecuadorian embassy. I think he's the most courageous compared to us because he's locked up there. But what Pamela is doing, and I think what is really big, and no one could have imagined that, is that when you comment the Gilles Jones, when you comment Salvini, when you comment Trump, or Sebastian Kurz, as you did a few days ago. It has a way much bigger influence than if I say it, than if Daniel says it, or someone else says it, because it comes from an unexpected place. But what I really like is that you will not become expected. You know, in the sense you will always do something even more unexpected, and that's what I'm looking for.